Hi everyone, welcome to a new video. Today we're going to learn something new. We get an error here. We want to fix in Kali Linux using PHP MyAdmin. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna say service start. We start starting the server. Service start. Apache, it's gonna be Apache to start. Okay, we start that service. Okay, also we go to service MySQL start, then we start also that service. Once we're done with that service, we're gonna go to our browser, then we look into, we go to localhost. Then say enter. Okay, you can see our Apache 2 is working. Then we go forward slash php myadmin, then enter. Okay, php myadmin is also here. And guys, I did show how to install php myadmin in Kali Linux. I have one of the videos, the very good charming videos I made for 2019 and also 2020, because many things change every time, every year. So I'm using Kali Linux 2020.3. So now here we're gonna go and log in using root, and we put in root. You can see that we have that error which says MySQLite real connection. The code is HY000/1698, access denied for user root. Okay, then let's try to, you know, when you newly it's a newly installation installed software, it won't work. So let me leave root and blank, and also let me try root and say 123.1.2.3.4.5. Then we say okay, we still get the same issue. Okay, that's fine anyway. Okay, since that is okay, it's giving us trouble, we don't care, we don't mind, we're gonna fix. That's the reason why we're creating this tutorial. So what you do, your first step is gonna be something super simple. We want to do what? We want to log into what? To do what? You say you, we want to log in to access the MariaDB client shell. That's what we have to do. So firstly, we use the command called sudo. Say sudo, and then we say space mysql space minus u, then we say root, then minus p. Okay, look at the command, copy it, and you analyze it, then you run that. We're gonna say enter. Remember, those are all small caps, small letters. We say enter. Okay, it says command not found MySQL, because it's my, okay, sudo MySQL. I made a mistake in that command, I'm sure. Minus u root minus p. Then we say enter. Okay, it asks you for the password. And if it asks you for the password, then you say root. Then you don't have password. It doesn't give you the password. You say your MariaDB connection is 41, server version 10.3.24, MariaDB 2, Debian building, whatever, unstable. So this simply means we don't have access to that. And what we're gonna do, once you see this screen, this is the best screen ever for you, because it simply means you're gonna be able to do what? To create yourself a new user. So the creating a new user is one of the new steps, the second step we're gonna do. So, and that's what is okay. So now what you do here, you're gonna say create, that's gonna be capital letter create, then Then you put user, then you put space, also you put caps. Okay, here you can, I'm saying single quotes, inside the single quotes put in any name of the user you want to use. You get me? For instance, here I'm gonna create a user called test user. Don't forget the user's name. Let's make it small letter. Test user. Once you've done with test user, go and put a space. Then what's gonna be next? You're gonna say at, no space there. You say at, the at sign. Then you say localhost. Okay, after that, at localhost. Then after that, you have to put a space. Then you say identified by password. Then you put the password you want to put. I'm gonna say identified is gonna be capital letter IDE. Okay, N, okay, T I F I E D, identified, space B Y, which means by. Then you're gonna put in quotes the password you want to use. Which password should I use? I want to use test user, to also test user, the username, then the password. I'm gonna make it 12345. Okay, I'm gonna come here and say tip 12345. Okay, then you say done, and you say okay, enter. Once you press enter, it should show something. It say okay, create user test. Okay, create user space test user, then you say at localhost, then space identified by, space then password. Then it was supposed to have a what? I wonder if it did, the command worked. It we lost something small here. Let's see if that gonna work again. No. Let's go and we missed out something small, but it's fine. We're gonna redo this command. It's okay. We're gonna do this time. We're gonna create another user. Okay, let's try to see if we can log in using that user. We can. It could be possible that we can log in, because we forgot the semicolon only by the end. Maybe it have created the user for us, localhost, and say test user. Remember, our user is called test user. Then the password is called 12345. Then we say okay. It gives us this error. It simply means the access was denied. Okay, so remember that we went to another terminal, so we're gonna just save time and recall the commands. This one of the commands, doesn't give us sudo. Okay, let's do that. Guys, follow, please don't forget to follow. Okay, when it asks you for the password, put in the password to be sudo. Okay, once you're done with that, we're gonna now remember what to do. We did. We're gonna do login to the way we've done on the first, using the first command we used, which was saying that MySQL sudo or MySQL. Then we say minus u. Then we say root. Then we say minus p. This is used when you specified a password. You get me? Predefined when the user has a predefined password. So we don't have that. Let's take out the p and minus p. Then we say okay. Once we hear, remember that before we used when you have a defined password. But now remember, we don't have a password. So now we just logged in like this. So which is okay. So now we're gonna now try to watch to create a user, as we said. So our user gonna be what? I'm gonna just paste the command, the what, the user test. This time we won't call it test, you never know what happened. I'm gonna call it MUSA, all small letters. Then the password also should be MUSA. okay, you're gonna look at the command and forget what remember we made a mistake. This time we're not making a mistake anymore. So the command, I'm gonna just paste it for you here. Okay, it says like create user, create space, create is capital letter, user, and then it says space, single quote, MUSA, single quote, then at localhost, space identified, space by, space MUSA, in quotes, single quotes, then colonies, semicolon, stuff like that. Then you say enter. After entering, you're gonna see query, zero row, whatever. If you see this, then you just know everything's super fine. So I'm gonna do the second command, which is gonna be to give the user the privileges. So now I'm gonna do it. That's why I'm avoiding making mistakes as I made before. So I'm typing the what everything before I do give them to you. So I'm gonna give you the command which is gonna grant all privileges to this user. So then we're gonna copy and paste here the command. I'm repeating it for you. It's gonna be grant all privileges on grant all privileges, though that is gonna be capital letters, then on space star on space star dot star space two which is a what capital letter, then quote single quote, you put the username which is MUSA, then another quote, then at local host space identified space by, then you put the password. The last part here is the password of the user. Then after that you press enter. When you press enter, if it shows you that, just know that you super fine. Are we together? Yes, we are together, why not? So after that, then let's try to log in and see if it's gonna work. If it doesn't work, then we're gonna restart the server and we say yes, it worked. So what we needed to do here is to create a user, because the root and root the root user in Linux, when you do install phpMyAdmin, it doesn't give you that access. So you have to create your own user and give that user all the privileges to access all databases, whatever. So now at the stage where we are, we can even create what one database if you want to. So you can just click here and create a database called my new db. Okay, after creating the db, you just say okay, we're done. You can put a table here and say my tb, which is my table, put it four columns and stuff, whatever, then you start working. Guys, I hope that helps. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. I'm gonna put the steps into the description so that you don't get lost. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video. If this video was helpful to you, please don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to share, don't forget to comment, don't forget to click that bell. Thanks for watching. We're so glad that we managed to fix this problem. See you in the next video.